Next, we are going to start with second stanza. The second stanza begins like this. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, in the first stanza, the jet was 6 inches away from the ground. Next, the jet reached 10,000 feet. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran. Here, you can see some houses near the river. This is the way in which people started occupying spaces. They started living near the rivers, near the small streams, because water will help them in vegetation. It was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran. We all know that Trichy is a good city. We have two rivers. Do we have two rivers or not? Kaveri and Kollidam. So, people started living in the area where the rivers ran. As we know that, water is the main source for survival. That was the reason given by the poet also. This happened when the jet reached 10,000 feet away from the ground. It was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran. Things are clear for you children? Next. Why the valleys were populated? First he gave us the reason why the cities were near the rivers. Now he is telling why the valleys were populated. It is also because of water. In valley you can see, valley is a place between mountains, between hills. Have you been to valleys children? How the valleys will be? It will be between mountains, it will be between the hills. Why the valleys were populated? It is also because of vegetation. The background of it were vegetation. Valley will have a good water source, good source of water over there. That is the reason why the valley started to populate. Next, the logic of geography. I have given you the picture of globe over here. When you look at the globe, what you can see over there? All this blue color represents the water and this green color represents the landforms. You can see here, the maximum area is covered by water than the landform. Have you got it? The same you will study in geography also. When we see the topography of earth, the maximum area is covered by water than the land. This is the logic of geography. When we see the next line, that land and water attracted man was clearly delineated. Underline the word delineated and write the meaning of it. The meaning of the word delineated is shown. What is the meaning of the word delineated? Shown. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted man, was clearly shown. Is it clear for everyone, children? In the previous lines, wait, I'll show you the previous lines. Here we could see why the valleys were populated. Here we could see cities where the rivers ran. In this picture, you could see water. And in the next picture also, you can see valleys with evergreen plantations, vegetation. Water helps them as a source. So, in the previous picture, we came to know that why the cities were near the rivers. And here, the reason is also stated why the valleys were populated. What are the reasons? The reason is, the logic of geography shows that land and water attracted man. It was clearly delineated. Delineated means shown. It was clearly shown. We could see like the poet is trying to explain it from the logic of geography. How the people started to cultivate lands and why they have started their vegetation near the water forms. People started living near the water forms and they started with their vegetation. Even when we see Chennai, it has a river. But we started occupying the rivers with the houses. Okay. And here also it was clearly delineated why the landforms are there. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, things are clear. People started to occupy the areas where there are water bodies. Is it clear for you children? This is the line which gives the explanation that land and water attracted man. That is why we could see cities will have a river by its outer. And now people started building houses even in the rivers also, in the river beds also. That is why when we have floods all, we get a major destruction. Have you got the idea of the second stanza then? Shall we move on to the next stanza? Come to the next stanza. The same image. When the jet started to reach 6 miles high. Jet rose 6 miles high. What is the meaning of the word rose, children? Rose is the past tense of rise. So, when the jet rise 6 miles high, what the poet is able to see now? It was clear that the earth was round. When the jet rise 6 miles high, it was clear that the earth was round. This is the topography of earth. It was round. We used to say that earth is spherical in shape. What is the shape of earth? Earth is spherical in shape. So here I have given you that the topography of earth, which clearly explains that the major part of the earth is filled with water. Major part of the earth is filled with water. Only in limited areas you could see the landforms. So this is the explanation of the topography, earth topography. Now, and that it had more sea than land. This is what I told you, no? The same idea the poet is also bringing out. What is the idea? That it had more sea than land. When the jet rose 6 miles away, he could see that the earth was round and it had more sea than land. But it was difficult to understand. For whom? Things are clear for the poet now. First stanza. What does the first stanza tell you? It gives you a picture that when the jet is 6 inches away from the ground, the houses, the buildings look haphazard. And the poet is trying to give his opinion that why the houses look haphazard over there. It is because the increase in population and it is because the growth in population, it is because the increasing number of houses. Second stanza, when the jet rose 10,000 feet away from the ground, he could see, I'll show you the slide, children, wait. When the jet went up to 10,000 feet, he gave us the reason why there were cities near the rivers. And he also gave us a thing like why the valleys were populated. Wait with me, I'll show you the slide. Now, when it comes to third stanza, when the jet rose 6 miles high, he gave us an idea that the earth was round, maximum space is occupied by water, only a few areas are there as land in the topography of earth. He is clear with that, but he has a question. What is the question? Read the next two lines of the poem. that the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across the cities and to kill. This is the question mark. Read the line with me. That the men on the earth found causes to hate each other, to build walls across cities and to kill. What are the things which is described here? There is hatred in human being. They started to build walls. They started to kill people. Why it happens? This remains as a question mark for him. But it was difficult to understand. Try to feel it from the shoe of the poet, children, from the heel of the poet. Even we have such questions in our mind. Earth's topography has a reason why the cities are huge populated and why people started living near riverbeds, why the valleys are populated. But it still remains a question mark why there is hatred and why people wish to kill others, why they build walls across cities. What is the reason? We don't know. There is no love in humanity. There is no love in humankind. There is no humanity. From that height, it was not clear why. This is the last line of the poem. So when we see the topography of the earth, it is very clear why things look like that. But what is present in human heart? That is the thing which the poet could not understand. What is the feeling that is present in human heart? The poet could not get it. He is not able to answer that question and things are not clear for him. From that height, it was not clear why. Come to the previous slide. Why humans cause to hate each other? Why humans build walls across cities? They don't have any reason. This is the thing the poet is trying to bring out. And when he ends the poem with a question mark, he is trying to tell that he wants to convey it to the readers that why there is no peace in the world, why there is no humanity, why we hate each other. The poet Zulfikar Ghoose wants us to live a life which is peaceful. Will you have a good friendship with your friends? Will you be good in your home? Will you have peace in your home? Will you spread peace in your home? You have to do that. Try to be calm and serene in nature. That the poet needs. So we have completed reading the poem and I have explained you the poem. In next class, I'll discuss with you the poetical devices and we will talk about the message which is conveyed through the poem. Get ready for your next class. We will discuss the message which is conveyed through the poem and we'll talk about the poetical devices. Get ready for the next session, children, with the same question mark in your mind. What is the question mark in your mind? Why there is hatred in human being? Why there is no love? Why there is no peace in the world? There should be a question mark in each of your mind. Have this question mark in your mind. Why such thing is happening? There is no answer for it. Thank you, children. Meet you in next session to discuss the poetical devices and we can share things. What is the message conveyed through the poem? Thank you. Bye-bye.